Hey, how y'all doing?
How's everybody doing today?
I'm hoping blessed.
Yes, definitely.
You know, once again, you got two guys in a book, which is
the Bible.
Holy Bible. Yeah, because we're here to what, Jim?
Pump
you up spiritually.
Yes, amen.
So, anyways, today, actually, we're going to be talking about chosen. The chosen children of the Lord. Now, I got my chosen shirt. Jim, he has his chosen shirt. And the really interesting thing is that we didn't even call each other and say, Jim, what are you wearing today? Or Pedro, what are you wearing? No. We ended up wearing the shirt that says chosen without even thinking about it. Right, buddy?
That's right. Yeah, he chose it.
He did. He actually did. So, actually, that is going to be our theme today.
Yeah.
We pray that you are receptive and the Lord gives us wisdom to go out and touch your souls and your heart through the Lord.
That's right.
First of all, we want to say we love you and we're grateful that you are out there listening.
That's right. And if you're watching this right now, we ask you that you like and share and push the bell to get notified when we're on next.
You gotta subscribe, Jim.
Subscribe, yeah. Subscribe.
Like, yeah. Thank you. And the ones that are out there, thank
you
so much.
The YouTube stuff, you know what it is.
YouTubers. Mm-hmm. That's what it is. So enough of that. Let's go ahead and get down to what the Lord has given us. And we're gonna be reading out of the book of Deuteronomy in the Old Testament. Actually, Deuteronomy chapter 7, verses 6 through 8. Now, as we go along, it's talking about the chosen children of Israel, right? But it's going to be interesting how we're going to tie it together, and hopefully everything will make more sense, right, Jim, as we go?
That's right, yes.
So this is coming out of the Old Testament, and I'm going to be reading Deuteronomy chapter 7, verse 6. And it says, "For you are a holy people to the Lord your God. The Lord your God has chosen you to be a people for himself, a special treasure above all the peoples on the face of the earth. The Lord did not set his love on you nor chose you on the face of the earth. The Lord did not set his love on you nor chose you," I'm repeating that again, "because you were more in number than any other people, for you were the least of all peoples. Verse 8, "But because the Lord loves you and because he would keep the oath which he swore with your fathers," our fathers too, right, Jim?
That's right.
"The Lord has brought you out of the mighty hand and redeemed you from the house of bondage, from the hand of Pharaoh, king of Egypt." Now, I know it was the Old Testament, and it was kind of interesting how I had a little issue reading it, because the Old Testament is a little bit more
wordy.
That's the word, wordy, yeah. And older. Yeah. But as we come around, we are chosen ourselves. No matter what, the Lord has chose us too.
Mm-hmm.
I reposted something on Facebook that I saw that was totally awesome. It was a young man, Jim, that was saying, "Look, whatever you decide, it doesn't matter, because once the Lord says and has a plan for you individually or us individually, it's going to happen, because God's will is stronger than any other will around." Right, Jim?
That's
so
right.
So if the Lord has a plan for you, sooner or later, you will be doing things that the Lord wants you to do, because he loves you. And he loves Jim. He loves me. He loves all of you out there.
Mm-hmm.
So consider yourself chosen. All you got to do is open your heart to it.
You know what? I like better word than chosen is adopted.
Yeah?
It's adopted. God adopted you. You weren't part of his family, but he said, "You know what? I'll pick him. I'll pick her. I'm adopting them, that person." You're adopted. That's even better, because people, if you're born to your mom and dad, there's no choice. That's their son. But if you're adopted, he chose chose you everyone. And there's a little shorthand thing here. You know how he said it was different? Deuteronomy's written different, and because it was written by the Pharisees, right? Well, right. It was written, it's God's word, and it's written down by the Pharisees and stuff. The New Testament is written by a carpenter. It's written by
about a carpenter.
Yeah. It's written by a fisherman, by a prostitute, by normal people, not like people, normal people, you know, not the scribes and the Pharisees and stuff. They're written by normal people.
Yeah, and the way it is in my notes down here, it does connect to our modern times.
Yes.
So when you hear people or messages from the Old Testament, it's not just because the speaker or the pastor or whoever or the preacher is stuck in the Old Testament. There is a connection. So in us, the same thing with us. We're all chosen, okay? Mm-hmm. We're all chosen by the Lord. And Jim said adopt. That's fine.
Yeah.
But we all belong to the Lord. And in the notes here, it says, how did Israel deserve to be chosen above all of the other nations at that time? Okay, notice it says time. It wasn't a matter of Israel's merit because they weren't, you know, come on.
Nobody has the merit to be, like, all have sinned even back then, right?
That's true. But of God keeping his promise to their ancestors and our ancestors, mm-hmm. which is Abraham.
Yes. Yeah, I'll make you a father of many.
Just as God chose the nation of Israel, he has chosen all believers. He's talking, now we're jumping back to modern times. He's chosen all the believers right now. Even the ones that are out in sin.
That's right.
He still chose you. Like I said yesterday, said sinners and Christians, God loves us all the same, right, Jim?
That's right.
So he's chosen all believers today to be part of his treasured possession. So no matter what, we're still treasured possessions of the Lord. He chose us.
Mm-hmm.
He chose the people of Israel and the Old Testament, but in the New Testament, with Jesus Christ coming and dying on the cross for us, we were all chosen, okay, for his possession. Similarly, it is not because of our merit. See, God's mm-hmm. grace and love is so powerful. It's not because of we did good or we helped the person on the street or we feed the hungry. He chose us because he loves us.
That's right.
That's right. We can do all the stuff to help people and show up, but if we don't accept Christ as our personal Savior, it don't amount to nothing, Jim.
Mm-mm.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
So it's not because of merit that he has come. We have come to faith in Christ instead. God chose us out of his goodness and grace. So God chose us because of his goodness, his love, and his grace for us.
A good example is Jesus. He's like, Jesus? What do you mean Jesus? Think about Jesus came when he started his ministry. Who of all the people in Israel, who did he go to first? Did he go to the Pharisee? Did he choose them first? Did he choose them first?
He chose who?
He chose a prostitute, a fisherman, a tax collector. These are the people he chose first. He chose them. He didn't choose the royal guard, or he didn't choose the Pharisees or King Herod or anyone. Caesar. He chose these people first.
Yeah,
like he chose you first.
Yeah, and that's the awesome part about it. Remember when Jesus came to this world. He came in a manger, right?
Mm-hmm.
He came in a barn. And where they laid him down, that was a place where animals feed, where animals drink water. That was his crib. So he didn't come in the way they thought, the Pharisees and some of the higher religious men. They actually actually were a major part in crucifying him. He came in, it's quiet. Now, second time around, that's a whole different story, buddy.
Yeah,
all of us chosen will be going up with him, but is he going to come back as an innocent child? How's he going to come back, Jim?
He's coming on a white horse with a sword drawn, and he's taking his kingdom back.
That's right, he's taking them back, and guess what? No mercy.
No, the mercy is now. The age of grace is now.
Yep,
when he shuts that door, it's done.
Yep,
just like the ark.
Once it's done. You know, once that is done, it is done. There's nothing else that can happen. There's nothing else that could happen that we're doing.
Hey, how y'all doing?
Yeah, that's Brother Homer back there. I'm sorry, caught us off guard. Yeah. That back there is our Brother Homer. We also have other projects, but talking about the chosen part is that the Lord chose all of us, and it's up to us to accept Him in our lives. Right, Jim?
That's right. Yeah, this is now the time to choose, because you're chosen. Sounds weird, but that's it.
Yep.
Choose to be chosen.
That's right. But remember this, when Jesus is knocking on the door, it's up to you to choose to open that door. It's your decision. Now, I don't know who I'm talking to right now, but one thing that it's been pulling on me is that someone out there right now is in a lot of pain, a lot of emotional pain, Jim. Uh-huh. All you got to do is say, yes, you are a chosen one. I don't know who you are, obviously, but the Lord will get you through what you're going through right now.
Yeah, that's true. Like, you might be suffering, and you're angry about the world, and you drink a lot, and you're not happy with your life. Well, guess what? Jesus, the very first person He chose, was an angry, drunken fisherman named Peter. And then there was someone who was greedy with money, and went against his father's ways, their parents' ways. That's Matthew. He chose him. And there was a possessed harlot.
Oh, yeah.
Mary. And He chose her too. These are the people He chose to build His kingdom that will last forever. These are the first people He chose. So He can choose you. I mean, nothing you can do that would keep away from what he if He chooses you.
That's
and
right.
He does.
He's already chosen you.
Yeah, that's right.
Whoever you are, I feel it. He's already chosen you. All you got to do is take that first step. All you got to do is accept Christ as your personal Savior. He's there. He's waiting. All you got to do is open the door. I don't know if it's a drug addiction. I don't know if you've been beat up. I don't know if you've been cheating. I don't know if it's an alcohol addiction. I don't know if it's lust addiction. I don't know what it is. But all you got to do is say, Lord, I accept you into my life as my personal Savior.
That's right. Jesus don't care what you did.
Mm-mm.
He cares about you, not what you did. Because what you did is in the past, and he can just make it all go away if you did, with His blood.
That's
whatever
right.
Whatever you thought you did wrong, He can just make it all go away, just like that. It's nothing to Him. It's no big deal. It's like, Jesus says, you accept me, I'll just make it go all away.
That's
nothing
right.
Nothing you did impresses me or it makes me go away. I said, because my blood will just make it wash away. All of it.
The interesting thing, He already knows what you did, even if you haven't told anyone.
Yeah,
right? Yeah. You know, it's kind of interesting, but it is, if you sit down and think about it, He already knows what you did. He already knows what's in your heart and your mind.
That's
right,
like the woman at the well. Yeah, he was asking questions he already knew the answer to. He just wanted to see if she'd be honest with him.
Yeah, and that's all you got to do is be honest.
Yeah.
You know, it's going to be struggles, but guess what? You're alive today.
Yeah.
You're here now, and for some reason, you're listening to us. So, really, please, just open your heart to Christ. I guarantee you, from experience, from both of us.
That's right. Uh-huh.
It is the best decision that you will make. Is it going to be easy? No.
No, but He's there with you. The whole time.
He always is. He always is. He's made you an original.
Mm-hmm.
He already knows you before you were born. You know how they say about fingerprints, that's how they identify people, right?
Mm-hmm.
Did you know that, I wasn't going to go there, but I did, with thumbs up.
Uh-huh.
There's 66 lines on your thumb. And it's no coincidence that there's 66 books in the Bible. And every single thumb print is totally different than the other. It's an original. So God made you uniquely and just an original for His treasures, and so you can be living in His glory. It's not going to be easy, but it can be done. Right, Jim?
That's right, yes.
As long as you're a chosen one. There shouldn't be any worry about that at all. All you got to do is do your part.
That's right. You know, it'd be a good thing for them to choose too. They could choose to come to our church, the Whole World Gospel Center. I think you have our sign there. We have a professional sign, so we get it right, so you guys know, exactly where to go.
Our wives get on it. Well, my wife gets on me. Hey, hi, Lucinda. Look. We got it right this time. Look.
Here's our address, Whole World Gospel Center, at our 10 a.m. on Sunday and 6 p.m. on Wednesday. We have Bible study, and we'd love to see you there. Also, this is our church, and our church needs a new AC unit. And if the Lord leads it on your heart to give to help us with our new AC unit, it's $11,000. So we have a PayPal and also a Cash App on our Facebook and also on our YouTube. If the Lord leads it on your heart to give to our ministry, we appreciate it. And other than that, we love to see you here sometime. We also have a drive-through prayer that we start every...
It's this Saturday.
This Saturday, but we'll have it on and off this Saturday. In front of our church is a drive-through prayer. If you need prayer for healing, Jesus wants to heal you. He wants to make you the very first one to be healed. And all we ask, if you get healed, is to come to our church and testify you were healed in Jesus' name.
Yes, it's incredible that there is plenty of... God's everywhere. Like I said, you can walk into a bar and you say the name Jesus. Everybody knows that name.
That's right.
And they're all miserable. So don't be miserable anymore.
No.
Don't be miserable. There's no reason to be. You know, just be the person that God made you to be. His or her, his either son or daughter. Not this he-she stuff, the way society is today. No. No.
Oh, I
got
you.
God made you.
Before we go, I got something really good. My preferred pronoun is chosen.
There you go.
Chosen by Jesus Christ.
I love that. You know what I mean? You know, they're all talking about, I'm he, she. No, you're not.
I'm chosen.
That's my, I'm chosen too. Yeah. So you can be chosen also.
That's right.
Just remember, we love you. Jesus loves you. God loves you. And look, you can put comments on the bottom. And if you need prayer, just let us know on the comments.
That's
right.
We will pray for you.
We have no problem with that. And just and all we're asking is to give God a chance. And I guarantee you, that'd be the best decision. He's going to fill you whole. He loves you. So in saying that, we do appreciate your support. Right,
yes,
Jim?
We do. Thank you very much for the support.
Putting up with two guys in a book, which is a holy Bible, right?
That's right.
And you guys know we're just normal, the guys out there. Buffalo Bills fan, Pittsburgh Steelers fan. But one thing we do, we're the number one fan of, and number one, our God is number one.
Amen.
You know, I'm a fan of the Lord. I'm a slave of the Lord. I love the Lord with all my heart. And one last thing, and I know it's corny, but people like it, because we're here to what? Pump you up spiritually. God bless.
God bless.
We'll see you next week.